Very much indeed. The Prime Minister lauded the National Health Service at the Conservative Conference as one of the finest healthcare systems in the world, a vital national institution. But has protecting the NHS become a political fetish, getting in the way of providing proper care for the elderly, for instance, which then costs the health service dearly? That's the suggestion from the former Conservative Health Secretary, now Chairman of the NHS Federation, Stephen Dorrell, and he's attacking what he calls the insane economics and bad social policy of starving councils of cash to look after the elderly. He joins us from Westminster, and also in our studios there is Maria Caulfield, who was a cancer nurse before becoming a Conservative MP for Lewis. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Stephen Dorrell, why insane economics?
Well, it's insane economics because what you're doing, if you cut back on care in the community, cut back in, on support for elderly people, for people who use drug and alcohol services, for the schools who provide mental health support and so forth, if you cut back on all of those things, what you're doing is using the National Health Service as a kind of extended community care system. It's not designed for that. That's not what it's staffed for. And it, much more important, actually, than any of that, is the social policy implication that people become dependent on the health service. They become iller than they need to be because we're not providing, too often we're not providing, the support that good public services can provide for, to enable people to lead more normal lives.
Maria Caulfield, do you have some sympathy with that?
I do, and there's definitely an argument that says if you don't fund social care properly, the NHS will end up picking up the costs somewhere down the line anyway. But for me, it's not an either-or argument. You know, we do need to be increasing funding in the NHS because people are living longer. Conditions like prostate cancer, for example, that was an acute illness many years ago is now a chronic illness that people live with rather than die from. So we do need to invest in new technology and new treatments, but that shouldn't be at the expense of funding social care properly.
What do you think about that, Stephen Dorrell?
Of course I'm in favour of properly funding the National Health Service. I'm strongly in favour of that. But what I'm also in favour of is ensuring that people have support to lead lives that don't lead them to depend on the health service unnecessarily. That way, we deliver the best possible health care to those who need the acute services of the health service. But we also enable people to lead more normal, healthy lives in the community rather than becoming dependent on NHS services when they don't need to be. We should not accept that demand for NHS services is a given. You can intervene, you can help people lead healthier lives and avoid some of the increases in demand on the health service that we're currently experiencing.
But would you be willing to see the NHS losing money and that being given to councils to do this sort of thing? Or are you talking about more money, which is always a problem?
Well, when Simon Stevens set out the five-year forward view for the NHS, he made it clear that the additional resources that the government provided for the health service in last year's spending round, that would suffice, provided the full range of public services within which the health service works were themselves funded. Now, Simon Stevens, chief executive of NHS England, was himself on the record this summer saying if there's more money to be spent, it should be spent on social care, partly for economic reasons, but we should get away from the economics and focus on people's lives. If we don't provide proper social care, people are ill when they don't need to be. They become dependent on the health service when they don't need to. And that's, as I said, not merely bad economics, but it's very, very bad social policy for the individuals concerned.
Maria Caulfield, you both seem to agree that there's a need to bring health and social care together. It's got backing from many people in the Labour Party and the Lib Dems. It's their policy. Is it going to happen?
Well, it's starting to happen, but not really fast enough and not in a consistent way. So there are pockets of the country where better care funding is definitely transforming care, because as a nurse, I find it very frustrating that some things are classed as social care and some things are classed as health care. And actually, if you're looking after someone holistically, what they need in terms of care should be across the board. So for me, it is happening, but not consistently enough. And, you know, what I would say is it isn't just about funding as well. My constituency is in East Sussex and has the highest number of 85-year-olds in the country. And while we've got funding for services, we often often can't get those services because of lack of staffing or lack of provision. So sometimes people are waiting maybe a couple of months in hospital waiting for a nursing home place, not because there isn't the funding available, but because there aren't the places available locally. And that is also an issue that we need to look at.
Maria Caulfield and Stephen Dorrell, thank you very much indeed. Brings us to today's closing headlines. Russia's President Putin has called off a visit to Paris after he was told that talks with François Hollande would only be about the war in Syria. The House of Commons is holding an emergency debate.